Hello everyone. Today I welcome you to my show Computer Wednesday. Today we're going to talk about why desktop is king in episode number 3. So let's get started. So you have to understand one thing quite crucial to computers is that physics plays a much more important part than people realize. Now, one thing you have to understand, it's all about volume. So think of it this way, you have magic juice and you have 1 liter container. How much magic juice you can put into 1 liter container? Answer would be 1 liter. Now imagine you had 2 liter, you can put more. So that's why if you have a technology that is similar for computers and laptops, there will always be a scenario where desktop will be more powerful just by the fact that it has more volume, the physical size is larger. Second, this is much more crucial and important nowadays than it used to be, is heat. Now, modern laptops nowadays can consume as high as like 80 watts of power while running on the wall adapter. And you must have seen like many laptops disable their graphics card while they are running on battery. This is to preserve battery life. However, you have to also have to understand, even though modern laptops have very good cooling system for their processor and graphics card, in case of discrete graphics card, they are the only two components that are cooled. Nothing else is getting cooled. The motherboard specifically is getting fried. Like there is not enough airflow inside the chassis of a laptop that things will be cool. Now, this is the reason why laptops don't last if you run them at their 100% capacity. Like let's say you are an engineering student, you have a very powerful laptop and you are running CAD simulations. Suffice to say, your laptop's not gonna live very long, and it could be because you know CPU gave out, or graphics card blew up, or motherboard, or the power supply became too hot and started to give noisy power. Basically, it's too unbalanced in electrical sense, and it will cause a premature failure of your equipment. So there is not that much you can do about this. This is an inherent limitation caused by physics. Now you might decide that you can put your laptop into, you know, a laptop cooler, but given the fact how they are designed, your air is still not being circulated through the motherboard is still getting fried. That's the biggest problem with the heating of a laptop. So these are the two physical causes of why laptops are not as powerful as a desktop. Now we have to understand one thing about laptops. They are expensive. Now they should not be expensive. Now to think about this, think of it in this way. You buy a desktop, you buy components from every manufacturer, you buy components from different shops, different online vendors, different. Even though you are buying just a desktop, let's say just a piece CPU unit of a computer, or let's say keyboard, mouse, everything could be bought from different sellers. And yet somehow, even with this many inefficiency, you somehow end up with a computer that is cheaper and a laptop that is shipped to you in a simple box, which has everything in it, still somehow cost more. The reason for that, it's twofold. First, there is no standardization on laptops. That is the biggest reason why laptops are so expensive. There is no idea how to make a laptop standardized. Like you might say laptop graphics card standardized. No, they are not. First, like you can't just go out and buy them. And even if you are a manufacturer, let's say you are Dell or HP, and you want to go to Nvidia and be like, hey, give me this much card, they will ask you the TDP first, like what is your thermal capacity, like how much energy your laptop's cooling system can dissipate. Based on that, they will redesign their desktop graphics card to fit into that containment system. So the lack of standardization is the sole reason why it's so expensive. Second reason, laptops don't benefit from what's called economy of scale. Now this is a company's fault, is that when laptops were becoming more useful, every company started to make way too many laptops. They were not like category laptops. They were not like, okay, desktop replacement, ultra portable laptops. They were making laptops from cheapest range to maximum range. And they were not just upgrades to each other. They were like completely redesigned, completely different chassis, completely different. This increased the cost way too much. Like that's the sole reason Apple was able to give such a high quality iPhones at the beginning. Nowadays even Android can match it, but in the early days the sole reason Apple could even match the quality was very simple, because they were only focusing on one mobile, one thing to rule them all, and it did. suffice to say. So laptop manufacturers, because they are manufacturing way too many models, way too many subcategories, and each of them itself might even have subcategories, it's a very, very tedious production, and it's ludicrously expensive. So if laptop manufacturers were like, okay, we're gonna make one desktop replacement and one portable edition, that's it. Like, one will have as much power as they can feasibly put that year, and next one would be as portable, as practical as they can make it. They can reduce the cost quite a lot. However, because of the giant product lineup, it's quite expensive. So these are the two cost aspect. Because there is no standardization, there is no mass production. And even if there is a mass production of something, every company keeps changing them internally. So we ended up having a world where laptops are more expensive, which should not be. So the point comes, if this many side effects exist, they are more expensive, they are less powerful, why the heck they are so popular nowadays? Well, in recent years, laptops, CPU and RAM capacity has become good enough that you can actually do normal work, basically high-end media consumption. Basically, you can binge watch Netflix nowadays, and you can watch YouTube and all that. And all things considered, laptops have reached a point where they are powerful enough for almost 80% of the public, and they get the job done. Like, a programmer is not gonna need, you know, GTX 1080 Ti for like, you know, the programming assignments and all that. So it serves more purpose nowadays, and if you need more power, you can buy desktop laptops. And nowadays, you might say you have laptops that are using desktop grade hardware, sometimes direct desktop CPUs. They still have the same issue. The chassis is so small, there is no airflow in the chassis. They might have four or five fans, but they are all cooling the same thing. The CPU cooling and GPU cooling, everything else is getting roasted basically. So if you might find a laptop hard drive dying soon, this might be a one of the cause, leading cause to it. So you have to understand, desktop cannot be beat unless you, like, you know, bring i7 laptop and ancient Pentium desktop. If they are both have the same technology, laptop simply does not have enough power. The reason laptops are expensive is because of, well, no standardization and no too many product lines. So this was my episode where I told you guys why desktop still is the king, and it's not going away anytime soon or ever, practically speaking. So I hope you like this episode, and I hope to see you next episode of Computer Wednesday. Thanks for watching. If you liked it, please like. If you dislike it, please dislike. Leave a comment and subscribe and press the bell if you're free. So thanks for watching.